Okay, we are in lesson 8, the trumpets. Day 1, you were supposed to read Revelation chapter 8, verses 1 and 2, which talks about holy hush or silence in heaven. Then the Revelation 8, 3 to 5, incense rising. So the angel has a censer and a in his hands that is filled with the prayers. Then Revelation 8, 6 to 9, 21 and 11, 15 to 9, the trumpets sound. So then the some trumpets and what happens to each, there's a tabular column. Then Revelation 9, 1 to 12, the stars and the locusts. Then Revelation 9, 13 to 21, the angels. So these are the things we are going to study today. So there was silence in heaven. So Revelation 8, 1 and 2 talks about silence. So silence is like a breathing space, or angels are silent so that the prayers of saints could be heard, or cry of martyrs could be heard. So when you talk about half an hour in heaven, we don't have any watches to measure the time. So it is John's estimation that it was fallen about a half an hour. So this is a relative thing. Like if I'm speaking, I'm giving a sermon for 30 minutes. So in that, if I stop for 5 minutes, so it seems to be a very long time. If I stop for 5 seconds, it may not be a long time. So in the same way, it could be a time that we can say, which is relatively about half an hour. That's what we can say. So after that, silence, holy hush, what happened? There were 7 angels with trumpets. John saw angels with 7 trumpets. So when you talk about trumpets, we have to go to the Old Testament. So we always try to understand the meaning of Revelation from the other scriptures. So in this, we see that 7 trumpets. What are the 7 trumpets? How trumpets are used in the Old Testament. So there are 3 things, 3 meanings. First is, it is called for war. So whenever God calls, or whenever the nation goes for war, they will sound the trumpet and people will be ready. They will gather together and they will go against the enemy nation that are invading them. Then call for Jewish assembly. The tabernacle, when they cross the wilderness, so the people of God were around the tabernacle, and we see that they were gathered together whenever there was a trumpet call. So gathering of people of God, then going for war. So the other thing is, enemies are thrown into panic. This also happens. So like punishment or warning or judgment. So we can apply these 3 things into the 7 trumpets. So it is called for war against unrighteousness. So it is also gathering of God's people, alerting God's people. So then it is judgment on the world. So then John says, angel with golden censer. So the golden censer has prayers of saints ascended from angel's hand. So prayer is always considered as incense before God. So thanksgiving is considered as the sweet smelling offering unto God. So here also we see prayer of saints. So that means prayers are very important for God. Prayers are heard in heaven, and prayers, God listens to prayers, God answers prayers. God may answer the prayer according to his divine will. So these are some of the things we have to remember. So the angel took the censer, filled it with fire from the altar. So the prayers itself is an offering, and the offering is mixed, or we can say mingled with the fire from the altar, and then it is thrown it on the earth. So when it is thrown, it is noises, thundering, lightning, and an earthquake. So what could have been the prayers? The prayers could have been the prayers of the saints who are persecuted, or the cry of the martyrs, or the cry of the righteous people. So Lord Jesus Christ said, Abel's martyrdom. So in the Old Testament, we see the blood of Abel cries unto the Lord. So in Hebrews, we say, Lord Jesus Christ's blood speaks better than Abel's blood. So when there is persecution, when innocent blood is shed, when people of God cry out, so God, in God's presence, they are received. So then what happens? They are mixed with the fire from God's presence. So when fire is mixed, what happens? It becomes the judgment on earth. So how does the judgment on earth happen? It happens, one is, because the saints of God cry out. Second, God's fire on the altar, when that combines together, that becomes the judgment. So God values prayer, set up lays by the fire of God and cast upon the earth. So when we talk about prayer, what kind of prayer we should do? There are many kinds of prayer. We'll not go into detail, but here you will see, like Daniel, Daniel prayed that the prophecy may be fulfilled, or what God wants to do, let it happen soon. So Daniel was reading the book of Jeremiah and found out that for 70 years, the nation of Israel will be in Babylon in exile. So then they will go back. So Daniel started praying according to the word of God, according to the prophecy of Jeremiah, we should go back. So in the same way, we can pray for the coming of the Lord. So many times when you go through troubles, when you go through adverse situations, we feel like, Lord, why don't you come? So it is too much for us. Everything here is very, very sinful. So it is mind-numbing. So it is not good. Why don't you come? So these prayers could be answered. The ascending incense denotes the prayers were accepted. So the incense, so the people's prayers reached heaven, and God answered it with fire, and that it ended up in the judgment of the world. Then we see the seven seals and seven angels. So if you look at the picture, we were looking at the six seals already. So then there was silence in heaven. Then there is seventh seal. So when the seventh seal happened, the seven trumpets begin. So the same way when the seventh trumpet happens, so the seven bowls of judgment will begin. So here we see a pattern that John sees, or John writes. So this is a pattern that God uses. So there are seven out there, six tens, and the seventh opens, then the next seven comes. The seventh of the next opens, another seven comes. So seven angels with the trumpet were ready to stand. The seventh seal was opened. The end did not happen immediately. It began a series of seven trumpets sound upon the earth. So some scholars think John describes the same events in different worlds with different details to teach something new. So that is some people's opinion. So these are all the same set of tribulations or the judgment that comes upon the earth. But John puts it in different words to teach new meanings. But some say it is, no, they are all different, different. The seven seals contains the seven trumpets, and the seventh trumpet contains the seven bowls of judgment. So this is the pattern we can see in the whole of Revelation. The first trumpet, what happens? So trumpet here we see it as judgment. So what is the judgment? Hail, fire, and blood. So the similar thing happened in Egypt when the nation of Israel, their slaves, and the Egyptian Pharaoh did not allow or let go the people of God. There was hail. So the water turned into blood. So this is something similar to that. So by that, what happened? One third of trees were burned. It is not sure if hail and fire were red in color. So they say it could be red in color, or it could be because of the fire, it could have turned red. So God brings judgment. So others may understand or interpret as natural consequence, or global warming, or ecological disaster, or environmental exploitation resulted in that. So it could be the secular people or scientists can interpret it that way. But as people of God, we know God is sovereign. So because the Lord said, even a bird will not fall from the sky on the earth without his will. If a small sparrow cannot fall without the knowledge of God, so one third of trees cannot be burned without knowledge of God. It cannot be an accident. It cannot be just a natural consequence. So this is God's warning, God's punishment, and God's judgment. And many people, even people who are not followers of Christ, they understand this is from God. Even Pharaoh, magician, said, this is finger of God. So these plagues are not ordinary thing. Yes, the first thing we try to imitate, but now it is finger of God. We cannot stand before God. So they also could perceive, but they are not coming under the lordship of Christ. They don't have the humility to accept that they are sinners. And God is sovereign. So they think they have the power and they have authority. So they continue to rebel against God. So the first trumpet brings one third of the trees are burned. So that means, so the world in which we live may not be sustainable for the whole population. So that may happen. So if you carefully watch the news, you must have heard about the heat wave in Canada. So the area that heat wave was, the area in which they never felt that. It happened again this week. So that means the second time it happened. So the second time, it's not just the heat wave, it is also fires in the forest. So thousands of trees are burned. So these are all indications. When we read Revelation and we see the newspaper, so God is telling us he is sovereign God. He is ruling. So he is active in the history of humanity. So that will call us to exercise faith on Lord and be humble to worship the Lord as well as bow down before him. So the second trumpet, Revelation 8:8-9, a great mountain burning with fire was thrown into the sea. So it was like a great mountain. It was not a mountain. It was like, it was similar. So it was so huge. So it is compared to a mountain. So what happens? One third of sea became blood and one third of sea creatures. So that means fish, whales, crabs, tortoises, crocodiles, whatever it is, died, and one third of ships were damaged. So it is again a warning. It is a huge thing. So if you look at the oceans, if you look at the sea, how vast they are, so how deep they are. So what happens? A great mountain, it could be a meteor. It could be a group of stars. So it could be the satellites man has sent above. So they all could be pulled down and it could fall on the earth, on the sea. So what happens? It becomes blood. Blood means it is polluted. So if it is polluted, it cannot be used. So it is polluted. What happened? 1/3 of the sea creatures died. So similar thing happened during the time of Moses. The Nile River turned into blood. So the creatures living there also died. And here, there's an addition. 1/3 of ships were damaged. So the ships which are going, there are many ships, cargo ships, warships, passenger ships, and then they have the cruises where the luxury liners, they go and they go as tourists. So all these were there. So what kind of ships were damaged, we don't know. But 1/3, that means it is a huge number. So the great meteor could fall in the ocean and pollute the oceans or the Mediterranean Sea. So some scholars think John knew only the Mediterranean Sea. He did not know Indian Ocean. He did not know Pacific or Atlantic Ocean. So maybe he mentioned only the Mediterranean Sea. But most scholars think, no. It is about the oceans, all oceans. So which is around the world. Then the third trump, the great star meteor falls from heaven, burning like a torch. So there is another sign. You see, it was, earlier we saw it was like a mountain. Here it is a star. The name of the star is Wormwood. So 1/3 of water becomes bitter, men die because of that. So now it is not the ocean. So it is on rivers, ponds, pools, lakes. So this water is potable water. Water that is used for drinking. If the ocean water is polluted, that may be okay. We can survive without that. But when the water, that is drinking water facilities, are affected, then what happens? The survival itself becomes a question. So 1/3 of water becomes bitter, and then what happens? They die because. So wormwood is a very bitter substance that also indicates sadness. So that means the water is not useful to drink. So it could be pollution, industrial pollution, or other kinds of pollution. But it also indicates sadness. So when a person drinks wormwood, it leaves a bitter taste in the mouth and he'll be sad, he may be angry. So that is what happens to humanity when the third trumpet sounds. So then, the fourth trumpet, what we see is 1/3 of sun, moon, and the stars were struck and there was darkness. Again, it is similar to the plagues in Egypt. So there was darkness. There was 3 days pitch darkness. They were not able to see anything. So there was no natural light, sun, moon, star, nothing like that. So in the same way, the fourth trumpet said, it is will affect the whole world. So 1/3 of the sun, that means. So people say we will go for sustainable energy. We will use solar energy. So if the 1/3 of sun is struck, what will happen? So moon is struck and stars are struck. So the night, the traveling may become difficult. So then there will be darkness. So or they say it could be 1/3 of the daytime could be lost. one third of the night time, there will be darkness. So something like that can happen. So then also there was a warning voice about the war. We'll be looking at that a little later. So understanding of the four trumpets. So what do we understand by the four trumpets? Lord judges all means of existence for humanity, such as food, water, and even you can say light. So man, human beings take it for granted. So the world, all people, they say it is nature. It happens automatically. So the sun will rise up every day. There will be monsoon, there will be seasons, there will be rains, and everything will be normal. So they take these things for granted. So because their mind is dull, and they are not sensing or they are not responding to God, so they are not eager to search the truth, God has to turn their attentions toward how he does that. So he hits or he touches the sources of food and water. And regular rhythm of days will be affected. The seasons will be affected. So they are not impersonal or natural processes. Already we said that. Scientists may try to explain or say this is what has happened or this could have happened. But people of God look in faith and see, yes, it is judgment of God. God smites one third but spares two thirds so that they get opportunity to repent. So this is God's graciousness in the midst of judgment. So yes, God is furious because of the sin of the world. So the sin is multiplied every day. Yet, God is gracious. God is loving. So two-thirds of the living humanity gets an opportunity. So then I looked, I heard an eagle crying with a loud voice directly, woe, woe, woe to those who dwell on the earth at the blast of the other trumpets that the three angels are about to blow. Yes, these were the four trumpets. Their effects were bad. Now it will become worse. So God gradually or incrementally increases the pain of humanity. So he tries to get their attention, tries to make them repent, tries to help them to have senses,